here it is. Lady Bird Johnson Park. All that dam right there, used to play as a kid.
Did you see the fish?
This is a big one.
There's some fishes that are coming out right here. I can see them.
Oh, yeah?
Matthias, over here.
Oh, yeah. Well, sometimes they're turtles.
She said sometimes they're turtles.
Yeah, that's probably a turtle right there.
A turtle?
Yeah.
Matthias, be careful, please.
Can I throw a rock in there?
No, why? What did that turtle ever do to you?
Wait, are there snapping turtles in here?
What is this?
I love snapping turtles.
Yeah, there's snapping turtles.
A baby one.
It's just Lady Bird Johnson Park. It's just, this is just a reservoir.
I don't see it. I don't see it.
So my grandfather's brother, my great uncle, he moved, he retired. He was like a watch repair guy and did clocks and all that stuff. You know, where they actually had to work with like springs and stuff. And he lived in California and smoked the hooch and everything. He was into the reefer madness up there. And but he when he retired from the watch stuff, he was kind of he liked to drink quite a bit of wine too, but he had tuberculosis as a boy, and he was here as a boy in Fredericksburg, Texas. And my great grandfather was the grave digger in the cemetery there. And I don't know how true any of these stories are, but this is what I heard. You know, he was like between 30 and 40 years old and was in the cemetery digging a grave. And I always want to think of like some gory Bela Lugosi kind of thing, but he like fell and landed on like a tool, or they had these cages around the graves, I guess, with little spears on the top, and it punctured his heart and it killed him in the grave. And I don't know if that was his full-time job or whatever, but that's just something that he did. They lived rather close to the cemetery. But that's the deal with that. But my grandfather, and not the one that moved, that retired here, and another uncle, his name was William, and my grandfather's name Herman, they went and were jockeys, professional jockeys. My grandfather used to race for Groucho Marx and Anita Baldwin in California. I mean, in all the different kind of racing triple crowns. And then eventually he went up to like Canada and raced there for a while. And then, and I'm not short. My grandfather was kind of short, but not really jockey short, but he was close enough if he kept his weight down. And his brother William, that he went to California and trained. He was a jockey for a while, and he wasn't as prosperous as a jockey as my grandfather was. And it's not very prosperous, I don't think. But he gave up being a jockey and became a horse trainer and a jockey. He trained jockeys too, and one of his accolades, I guess that's the word that I need to use, was Willie Shoemaker, who raced until he was like 50, and he trained him, and he's got he's my great uncle. He has quite a few trophies. He's in the Horse Racing Hall of Fame. He's got quite a few trophies in his repertoire of wins and from different ways, either being the trainer or training the jockey or owning the horse or whatever. But my grandfather gave up horse racing as soon as he got too heavy for it, and was briefly a stuntman in some of the movies. And I never really quite found out what movies they wore. He just told me the names, Ben-Hur, Spartacus, and I've tried searching for his name at the end credits as a stuntman, and there's just nothing. I don't know how to find that out. And a couple of other ones, and I don't even know if it was the black and white version or the colored version. Probably the black and white, but I'm not sure. But my my grandfather, eventually, after briefly doing that, he came back to San Antonio, Texas, and met my grandmother in Seguin on her farm. And they eventually ended up getting married, and they had my father and my uncle. Well, Uncle Ulrich, who moved to Fredericksburg after he retired from being a watchmaker in California, he came here, retired in Fredericksburg. And as a child, my grandfather used to bring me up here with him. And we used to catch catfish and bass. He liked to fish for catfish and panfish. I like to bass fish, and we caught quite a few. Well, he moved to the Luckenbach Apartments. I guess they were like a brand new, building, but it was like a retirement center, and they had like a retirement fee and all that. But they were digging a pond in the middle of the apartments, and so we used to use those big old grasshoppers to catch fish. But we in the middle of the apartment, they dug a big old giant for a pond, and so we came out here to this park, and the thing was probably a third of the way full of water, and we caught probably 20 fish out of here and put them in this pond. And if that pond, I went and fished it, I don't know, maybe 10-15 years ago, and it still had all these fish in there. And the catfish that we caught were I think they were channel cats, but they were kind of speckled, and that's what I ended up catching out of there. And then the bass and the panfish, and I think they were Guadalupe bass, or I don't know, I can't remember. But it was kind of ironic, but I don't see the Luckenbach Apartments. They may have knocked them all down and put up these big high rises. But my uncle and I were literally responsible for stocking that pond out of this river, the Perdinalis. All right, y'all take care. The Perdinalis River. Oh, you got it. You hit the river. I mean, that tree's still been the same underneath that. I wonder what kind of tree that is. Is that a pecan? Yeah. Cool. This one's probably a pecan, too. Or Osage. But they've been here forever. We used to have picnics just right here and over there.
When you're done, kid. Oh my God, there's even one right here. Yes, son. Can you please help me?
All right, the river, Perdinalis River. It's cool, man. There's the park for the babies to play. But yeah, they got a golf course over here. It's just a real cool park, man. My Uncle Rick and I used to come here when I was a kid. I wasn't much older than my nephews.